Hello my dear students, in this video session we are going to cover basics of computers. The computer components are divided into two major categories, namely the hardware and software. We already know that the hardware is a physical component, software is a imaginary component. So first of all, we are discussing the objectives of this lesson. I am preparing the PowerPoint presentation based on this lesson. We have discussed each and every slide one by one. Data entry operation, lesson number one, the basics of computer. The objectives, they explain the basic organization of the computer system and then explain different types of input and output devices and define the software and its classifications, distinguish between system software and application software, describe the computer language and its classification. In this video session, we have discussed first two objectives only for this. Next class we are discussing the remaining part. First, what is a computer? See, human being can do all the things, but why we are using computer? The human being is do all the things, but some manual errors may be occur. The system is a good result, it's producing a good results. Accuracy is a good. You do some large number in the mathematical functions, the human being it's get 100 members can do the same mathematical problem. It's any one or two members can be give the wrong results, yes or no? Yes. So that's why we are using computer. The 100 machines, you can enter the same large mathematical function for 100 systems, all the system give the same result. So that is a accuracy. The human being can be make a manual errors, but system cannot be make any errors. It's a good point for the character of the computer. Okay, the computer cannot do any mistakes. Okay, it give good accuracy of the results. And then second one, it can store large number of data, large values can able to be stored. You can't store how many mobile numbers you can register in your mind. You tell your father number and mother number and then some neighbors or friends, and then 100 or 200 members you can able to tell. This is difficult. Okay, but the PC can store all the lakhs of mobile numbers or some numbers can be stored. It is easy to store these things. Okay, and then performance also, it's a very high speed. Human being takes some time for do the mathematical, but the system would take for milliseconds of the frequency of seconds and finish that sums. Okay. So okay, that's what is put into one side, and then mainly we are discussing what is the computer for here. What is a computer? The computer is a device that transforms the data into meaningful information. The computer is a device that transforms data into meaningful information. All are tell again. The computer is a device. The computer is a device that transforms the data into meaningful information. Very important, the single line definition of the computer. Okay, the computer is a device, all are know that the monitor, keyboard, mouse, these all the things are devices. What is the transform of data to meaningful information? What is that? I'll give simple example. You take just a 12, number 12. Okay, you consider as 12. What is this 12? It's a serial number or height or weight or length or breadth or rupee. You can't tell anything only based on 12. Okay, yes or no? 12 matter which we can't tell anything. This is height or not, age or the something. Maybe it's a date also. So the information is getting from the data. The 12 is data, it's a raw fact. No meaningful from this. Okay, 12 is not a meaningful word, it is a raw data. Okay, you converted this raw data into the meaningful information. Age 12, rupees 12, okay, height 12, weight is 12. You can convert to this thing, you know. That conversion thing is called as processing. The final result will be called as information. The 12 is data, you process something, you get it the final result, you know. The age 12, that is the information. The 12 is, again I am explaining the same thing. 12 is data, it's processing something, get at the result, final result, age 12, for the statement, it's a complete information it's giving. No, age 12 is a, you get some information or not, you get some information, but 12 is not giving the meaningful information. The age 12 is giving some meaningful information. The meaningful information is called as information. The meaningless thing is called data. Okay. Sorry. Again, one more thing. Data can be anything like marks obtained by you. Various subjects. Data can be anything like marks obtained by you. The various subjects. It may also name, age, sex, weight, height, etc. All the students in the class. Computer can also define in the terms of function it can be performed. Terms of function it can perform. If system NLM பண்ணது அப்படினு பாப்போம். The computer can also define the term of functions it can be performed அப்படினு சொல்றாங்க. The first, accept the data. You can enter the data via keyboard. System can accept your data, no? Enter your name, you entering your name. That's mean accepting. You enter your name, the finally it's stored in some places, no? That's stored data. Example, you give enter the username and password, you enter your password, this password is correct or not, it's validating, no, that's called the process data. Retrieve the data, you already store the images or something in your mobile or something in system, you open it again, that's called as retrieve the data. You want to print that image or document, it's called print the result. In this functions can be do the PC. What are the functions? First one is accept the data. User gives some information to the PC. It can accept the data. And second one, store that data. Accept the data, it can be stored. Okay. And then it processing the data. And in case the user can be get it later on the given data, that's called retrieve the stored data. Okay, the finally the print the result in desired format. Next one, the computer organization. The computer organization is mainly classified. The computer is mainly classified in three categories. One is input unit, and another one is CPU, and another one is output unit. Okay, the computer is mainly classified into three categories: input, CPU, output. The CPU is again classified into three categories: CU, ALU, MU. CU, ALU, MU. CU means control unit, ALU means arithmetic and logic unit, MU means memory unit. We are discuss one by one on this. The block diagram of computer organization. User give our input data to processor. In this main rectangle box, it's called processor box, CPU. Okay, inside the CPU we have memory unit, control unit, arithmetic and logic unit. Finally, process the input data. User give the input, the processor process the input data, and finally it produce the output result. Okay, look at this. The input, example, keyboard is one of the input device. Yes or no? Keyboard is a input device. The you entering something from this keyboard, it's sent to the processor CPU. You look at this image, this is the CPU image. Okay, and process the some data to this, and finally it send into the output device. Example, monitor also output, it producing a some results. Example, you enter ABCD in the keyboard, the monitor will be display the thing. Yes or no? You entering something in the notepad, you enter via keyboard ABCD, it display into the monitor. Yes or no? Yes. Input device, this is the process of entering data and programs into the computer. We already discussed the computer is classified into three categories. One is input device, another one is CPU, another one is output device. If you want to give some information to the computer, user can able to give via input devices. For example, keyboard, mouse, webcam, and etc. etc. If you user can enter our name or something details using the keyboard. If you want to select any object on the screen using mouse. If you want to take any photos using webcam. In this devices are called as input devices. These devices giving the information to the computer PC. Yes or no? These devices are helped to give the informations to the computer PC. Who is giving this information? User. users can be entering the data or selecting the object using this input devices. This device information can be get it. Who is getting? The CPU is getting. The CPU and then CPU is processing this data and finally producing some results. Okay, the input device is a device. The device help to accepting users' information or data. Okay, again I am explaining this same thing. The input devices is help to accepting user information and send to the computer PC. It sent to the computer. The example keyboard, mouse, and etc. And then central processing unit. The central processing unit already discussed. The central processing unit is classified into three categories: control unit, memory unit, arithmetic and logic unit. Control unit is look like human brain. It gives some commands to the PC. You can do this. You can stop this in this type of instructions. The teacher is giving some instructions. No, you start up, you set, and the same like that. Control unit is giving the instructions. The pen drive stop your process. Monitor you do this. CPU you can do this. Instructions will be given. Who is giving the in this type of instruction? Control unit. Okay. The process of input, output processing and storage is performed under this supervision of a unit is called as control unit. யாருடைய சூப்பர்விஷனில் தான் இதெல்லாம் நடக்குது? கண்ட்ரோல் யூனிட்டோடைய சூப்பர்விஷனில் தான் த ஜாப்ஸ் வில் பி டூ இன்சைட் ஆஃப் த சிபியு. ஓகே, த நெக்ஸ்ட் திங் த மெமரி யூனிட். கம்ப்யூட்டர் இஸ் யூஸ்டு டு ஸ்டோர் டேட்டாஸ் அண்ட் இன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன்ஸ். கம்ப்யூட்டர் இஸ் யூஸ்டு டு ஸ்டோர் அண்ட் இன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன்ஸ். ஜஸ்ட் லைக் யூ ஸ்டார்ட் ஓப்பன் த நோட் பேட், யூ டைப் சம்திங், ஓகே, த பவர் will be shut down immediately. The data will be available in your notepad or not? Tell me. They're not available. Why? If you store this notepad, the data will be stored inside of the hard disk. Without storing, the data will be removed from the memory. That the memory is called as main memory. You can type something, no, you can enter some 10 lines in the notepad. Before save this document, the data will be stored inside of the main the data will be stored where it's stored before saving in the main memory. Okay, that unit is called as memory unit. Main memory unit is called as a memory unit. The computer is used to store data and instructions. Memory unit is helped to store data and instructions. The arithmetic and logic unit, it is helped to do some mathematical calculations, the plus or minus, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, in this type of logical and comparisons, in this type of mathematical functions, we are helped to do arithmetic and logic unit. Output, this is the process of producing results from the data for getting the useful information. User gives some input to the PC, the processor can do the some process, finally it producing some results. That result will be showing via output devices. This is called as output devices. This is process of producing results from the data from getting the useful information. Data learn the we have get it to the information. Information will be displayed where? Output device. Good. Choose the correct answers. Task of performing arithmetic and logical operation is called. Task of performing arithmetic and logical operation is called. Tell anyone answer. The task of performing arithmetic and logical operation. Yaar inga logical operation arithmetic operation perform pandra? Which one? ALU, editing, storage, output. The correct ALU is a correct answer. Good. The ALU and CU jointly or known as ALU CU edukulla irukku. Already we know that RAM, ROM, CPU, none of this. Which one is a correct answer? Select. Good. CPU, very good. The third one, the process of producing the results from the data for getting useful information is called. The process of producing results from the data and getting the useful information is called. Which one is answer? Output, input, processing, storage. Which one? Output. Very good. Thank you.